that is on the topic, Embracing the Future of Sourcing in an Intelligent Way. And the speaker is Mr. Amit Kumar, Sales Director, India, TAB, that is Tata Consultancy Services. Giving a brief introduction for Mr. Amit, he's a certified professional in supply chain management with 20 plus years of experience in procurement, digital transformation, and operations with expertise in source-to-pay processes. He is having cutting-edge knowledge of digital transformation techniques like cloud, artificial intelligence, mobility, analytics, and blockchain in the area of procurement. He has worked with organizations like Hindustan Aeronautics Limited and Infosys, and for the last 13 years, he is associated with Tata Consultancy Services. He is also one of the pillars behind the development of TCS proprietary cloud-based procurement platform and contributed immensely in delivering the value to TAP customers. Please welcome him with a huge round of applause.
So thank you so much. And I once again, on behalf of Tata Consultancy Services, thank you for attending this session. And today I will be talking more about, you know, embracing the future of sourcing in an intelligent way. You know, the focus would be mostly on the sourcing, but going forward, you know, before I start it, I would like to tell you a story. I think the previous speaker has also talked about a story about the camel. But here also, you know, I wanted to start with a story. Year 1933. Place was Germany. Okay, the German economy was in shambles. Region, World War I. Now, as part of Treaty of Versailles, Germany was required to pay how much? They have to pay war reparations, which is basically they were responsible for the war, and that's why the penalty that has been paid, that has been levied on that. Do you know how much? It was 132 billion gold mark, which was equivalent to 31.4 billion US dollars. And this amount has put Germany in debt. So Germany was in debt. Germans were demoralized. There was social unrest and, you know, no political stability. Even there was post-war hyperinflation, unemployment, uncertainty. This is the time when Adolf Hitler, I'm sure that you all would be recognizing this person. This is the time when Adolf Hitler and his Nazi party decided to exploit the crisis. And on 30th January 1933, Adolf Hitler became the new leader of Germany. And the rest is history. Moral of the story, you know, financial distress and inflation has the power even to change the course of history. And I think the history is again repeating. We can see the example of Sri Lanka. Yeah. So throughout, you know, throughout the world, what we are seeing, you know, stocks are falling, currencies is losing value, fuel is becoming more valuable, price of, you know, basic commodities are going up. And we from the procurement profession, we know even the supply chain is disrupting, okay? Now, why I'm talking, you know, about all these things? Because the most impacted profession because of all this uncertainty is procurement. We as a procurement professionals, we have lot of pressure. You know, that's why I say that procurement is not an easy job. Not everybody wants to join procurement. Earlier, it was an admin function. It was considered as admin function, but today it is a game changer. And that's why, you know, we are constantly under pressure from external factors, which I have just talked about, but internal factors are also there. You know, we are mandated to deliver savings. My earlier speakers, everybody has talked about savings, savings, savings. But you know that under such pressure, when we have to, you know, these economic conditions are there, we have to deliver savings, but where are the requirements? Requirements are unambiguous. Requirements are not clear. Okay, but we have been mandated to deliver savings. That is one. Now, we have been, you know, I think earlier speaker also talked about vendor management. We are supposed to manage a very healthy, great, awesome supplier relationship, right? Okay, everybody talk about that. You please manage supplier relationship. But constant is you don't have the budget. Okay, under the budget, you have to get best of out of your suppliers. That is where, you know, our job is not easy, okay? And now, you know, we all are talking about sustainability, ESG, okay? We are responsible for that too. So what I'm trying to say, that lot of pressure is there, okay? Now the time has come when, you know, ultimately there is no other go. If we have to survive in this profession, we have to revisit our strategies. And I think today there was lot of discussion, lot of approach, how user can adopt the system, what are the, how we can do, you know, strategies to make the changes in the procurement profession. So ultimately there is no other go, you cannot escape. Ultimately either we have to, you know, revisit our strategies, we have to align ourselves with the emerging business models. There is no other go, you cannot escape that. And ultimately you have to adopt to digital transformation technologies. That means, you know, this is something which is disrupting the industry, okay? Be it artificial intelligence or advanced analytics or automations, integrated system, IoT, blockchain, 5G, augmented reality, you name it. It's not that, you know, this is something which is going to come. This is something which is today, okay? And ultimately, you know, I am definitely agree that, you know, there is a, you know, category expertise that is required in profession. Negotiation skills is required in profession. But, you know, these are the technologies which are going to disrupt and it's not going to take your job. It is making you much more productive. Wherever you want to focus, that is where procurement comes into picture. And I think today I will talk about artificial intelligence, advanced analytics, and automation. These three drivers, we will talk it. And particularly, you know, I am going to talk about the strategic sourcing or, you know, S2C area. Now, if you really look traditionally, you know, from the source to pay cycle point of view, you know, it is basically, if you ask any sourcing or procurement professional, they say source to pay is divided into source to contract and procure to pay, okay, or purchase to pay. And then supplier relationship, it cuts across source to pay, okay. Now, traditionally, this is what, but now, you know, how the things are getting changes. Source to contract has to become more predictable, okay? Transactional procurement, which is P2P, has to become more automated. And the supplier relationship management has to become more proactive, okay? So that is how, you know, the things are changing. Today's session is mostly focused about the sourcing, how the industry is moving, particularly in the sourcing. So this sourcing basically, you know, where you identify the supplier, you know, you create a RFP, you float it, okay, get the bids, evaluate it, negotiate, and finally award. So, you know, what are the things that is moving into that particular sourcing function? I will talk about that one. So to cover that, the first one would be, you know, smart supplier discovery. I think sir has talked about, you know, potential supplier, but, you know, I will give you a technology angle to that one, how it is happening. The second one is AI recommended sourcing event and supplier. The third one is data driven e-auction. Sir, you have touched upon e-auction, but I will tell you how. And I think there was one question on cartelization. I will respond to that as well. Okay, number four is autonomous negotiation. This also, this topic has been covered, that, you know, what about the negotiation, but this is a new format of negotiation, autonomous negotiation. And in today's session, many of, you know, speakers have talked about commodity price forecasting. So how AI is powering this commodity price forecasting. So these are the topics that I will cover it in today's session. Now coming to smart supplier discovery. Okay, it is again, traditionally what you do, if I ask you as a procurement function to, you know, identify a new list of vendors or discover new vendors, traditionally there are only two approaches. You go to user department, ask, do you have any supplier for this? Have you worked with them? Okay, they give you a list. Okay, this is very plain and simple, but no contribution from procurement. The other is you ask a junior guy that, you know, please find out the potential suppliers, go to Google, and that for 3 weeks, 4 weeks, that guy, you know, type some keywords, identify suppliers, go into their individual website, try to find out what are their capabilities, build a, you know, list of 10-15 suppliers at the end of 3 to 4 weeks. But this process is not sustainable. Okay, it is very tedious, manual, lengthy. Okay, but AI has changed everything. Okay, in earlier, you know, sir talked about that how, you know, vendor, potential vendors can be found out. I am building upon that one. On right hand side, if you are seeing, you know, this is again powered by AI. AI has two components, okay, ML, which is machine learning algorithm, and NLP. Now, what it basically does, okay, there are algorithms which goes fetch the data from social media, like, you know, Twitter, Facebook, Insta, LinkedIn, and, you know, it gives the data. Then the other sources can be print media, industry association, news, articles, research reports, and the external data sources, commercial data bank sources like your LexisNexis, DNB reports, you know, ESG, EcoVadis. From those, you know, the millions of data comes in. And then on top of that, you know, the NLP algorithm runs. And once the algorithm runs, what it does, the thousands of suppliers, the data, it creates a data set. Now, when you create a data set, combined data set, another machine learning language algorithm runs on that, and it narrows down the supplier list from thousands to top 10 or top 50. This is what you will get in a fraction of days. It's not, you know, you are taking 30 days or 45 days. This is how. Now the list of that potential vendors that you got, now that can be used not only for the purpose of sourcing, it can be used for category management, it can be used for, you know, new product deployment, or even now, you know, these list of potential vendors, you can utilize it to enter into a new market. So that's how AI is powering the supplier discovery. It's a new way of supplier discovery, okay? So that is the one that is particularly in the sourcing area. Now coming to the second, which is AI recommended sourcing event and supplier. This is where, you know, now we have lot of sourcing platform where artificial intelligence is already embedded into it. Now it, what it basically does, for example, in case of recommended event, if you are trying to, you know, create an event, let's say for services or for laptops, and you just give a basic detail, location or budget, based upon that, AI programs runs into that one. It gets into the history of all past events, look into the overall cycle time of those events, or try to see that, you know, how many rounds were there in those events, and then try to analyze the scoring pattern. And not only that, it also looks what was the potential savings in those events. And finally, it suggests you some three, you know, top three events which you want to run. Okay, now just for you, it's very easy because now you have that, you know, list of those recommended, AI recommended events. You go through it and, you know, just clone it, make necessary changes, and your RFP is ready. Instead of taking, you know, days, you would be able to create, you know, single RFP within hours. That is the power of AI. The second is, you know, AI based, what you call, supplier recommendation. So what happens when you are creating a RFP, if you are adding 4 suppliers, okay, now the moment you create a RFP, you have all the basic data in that one. AI program definitely looks into that basic data. It goes into, again, the historical supplier data. It looks into, you know, for those particular category, for those requirement, you know, who were the suppliers who have participated in the past, what was their participation and award rate. The most important point is that participation is there. But out of those participated suppliers, how many of them got awarded? Because that would give you a good database of another set of suppliers. Okay, it looks into, you know, what was the supplier's pricing negotiation pattern. Sometime what happens, you know, the suppliers, you have to get into multiple rounds of negotiation to get those, you know, prices. And that is where it looks into those pattern and then recommend you the list of another 2 or 3 suppliers. See, the point I'm trying to make is that with 4 suppliers, you could run an event, no issues on that one. But with additional AI recommended suppliers, now you have a base of 6 suppliers. You run it, chances of, you know, potential savings is much, much higher in this case than the traditional way of running an event. Yeah. Now coming to the third one, data-driven e-auction. I think this is where the formats are changing. You know, typical reverse auction, you put a line description, vendors come, they participated. Things are changing, okay? From technology point of view, things are changing. Recent examples are Pro Kabaddi League and IPL. Now in these formats, you know, we now started loving this format, right? Every year we wait for this to happen. But the mechanism which is behind this is something that we should understand. The mechanism is that, you know, now even for bidding, you know, bidders, they don't go only by the name of Virat Kohli. They go how Virat has performed in last 10 matches, in last 1 year, in last 5 years. Okay, what is his consistency rate? Okay, the same way, you know, now they are looking for such kind of details. And that is where, you know, this is coming into your procurement world as well. So now the world is moving towards data-driven e-auction. And I think there was one question on cartelization. To answer that one, you know, now from technology point of view, you have IP-based tracking. Okay, there can't be collusion. If there are two suppliers who is bidding in the same room, okay, you can find out what is their IP, what is their location. So that is where technology is coming. Okay, so I hope I am able to answer your question with respect to cartelization. Okay, next is negotiation. See, negotiation is a very loving word. In fact, if you ask any procurement guy, okay, his views about negotiation, I think that's the best thing that a procurement guy wants to do. Why? Because negotiation is science and art, and everybody wants to demonstrate his skill. Okay, and as we all know, that savings is the target. So you try your best to negotiate, but things are changing. You see Hegelbot, okay, this Flipkart has used it during their billion day sales promotion. And this is where, you know, you as a customer, okay, you can negotiate with the bot. For example, you know, you are looking for a laptop. You can, you know, negotiate with that bot. Bot has, again, that bot is an AI-based bot. It knows its negotiation zone. It analyzes your, what you called as negotiation pattern. For example, if a laptop is for, let's say, you know, 20,000 rupees, okay, the basic laptop, you have the right, you can even say, you know, can you give me for 5,000 rupees? That kind of flexibility is there. But again, it is AI driven. So it knows that, you know, what is your negotiation pattern. And it really very, very interactive. I think if you go into Flipkart site and look into it, average time was 5 minutes when a deal was closed. So you just imagine if you bring this from e-commerce side to procurement world for all your tail end spend, you need not to negotiate. Okay, your time is much more important for strategic work, not for tail end spend negotiation. And that is where the Hegelbot will come into picture. Okay, you leave all these things to Hegelbot kind of, and this is again powered by AI developed by Google. So it is, you know, Google Assistant is supporting. So what I'm trying to say that, you know, this is the future. Okay, this is going to come in procurement. Okay, whether you accept it or not, 2 years down the line, you will see, you know, all tail end spend negotiation is happening through bots. Okay, the next is AI powered commodity price and forecasting. Okay, I think particularly in today's world, you know, where a lot of inflation, you know, recession, all those things are happening, you know, you can see that this is one area which makes a commodity manager. In fact, commodity managers are not able to sleep during night because then they don't know what is going to happen tomorrow. Okay, so I think this is one area where AI has immense power to support sourcing and commodity managers. Particularly how it basically works, that, you know, it picks up the data from 100 plus cost drivers, okay, like, you know, macroeconomic data, foreign exchange data, bond yield, supply and demand data. Even it looks into the market shift. I think you have brought that point that for negotiation you have to look into market trends. But yes, market shift traded volume, market sentiments. This is one important thing. Sentiments. Okay. Sentiments is one thing, you know, which as of now till date nobody was able to capture. But there is a technology, sentiment analysis. Okay, which does that? It looks into the sentiments of the market, try to predict it, combine it with social media posts, news articles, geopolitics, natural disaster, and it gives, or in fact, what it does, the NLP algorithm, it breaks structured and unstructured data and create the models to predict the pricing. And that is how the AI part comes into picture. And I think people have acknowledged that you cannot replace human intelligence with machine intelligence. Correct? I also agree to that one. On top of this, commodity experts' intelligence is very much required. And once you combine this powerful combination of AI and HI, this is called as HI. I think in coming days, you will see the combination of AI and HI, okay, to give you the commodity price forecasting. This is where, you know, you are going to head it towards. So I think these are the five digital transformation technologies that we wanted to talk about. Okay, now I think we are in the world, you know, where these digital technologies like, you know, 5G, blockchains, artificial intelligence, automation, they are already disrupting the business models. It's the time for us to embrace it. We cannot close our eyes and get escaped from the reality. So I think the only way to move forward is, future is here right now. Let's embrace it. Thank you so much. If you have any questions, I would be happy to answer that. And once again, from the family of TCS, I would like to thank you for joining this session and giving us an opportunity.
Okay, do we have any questions?
Yeah, please.
On the last slide, there was a picture of smart contracting. Anything you want to provide detail or how that happened?
Yeah, please. Yeah, this is the slide. Yeah, sorry.
Smart contract.
Yeah, smart contract. Yeah, what's the question? Yeah, this is one of the, you know, application of blockchain. Okay. Now, this smart contract, what it basically does, you know, like a blockchain, you know, it's where, you know, you enter the data and you cannot basically, you cannot change it. Okay, it is so powerful that, you know, it creates nodes. Okay, now what happens that you have party supplier, you have, you know, you as a buyer, right? You know, buying organization and supplying organization. Okay, now when they enter into a contract, okay, their contract will be kept into this. It's a kind of a smart contract, where all your terms, you know, be it the legal clauses, be it the commercial clauses, all are there. Okay. Now, nobody is able to change that unless until both parties agrees. Okay. So that is how the blockchain is making so impact on entire contract management that, you know, this specific things is going to be, you know, the game changer. In fact, if you look into this one, Merck's and other organizations, they have started using the concept of blockchain. So this is one of the application of the blockchain itself. Yeah, sure, no worries.
Okay, do we have any more questions?
I think there was one more question from them.
Hello everyone, I'm Yogesh. It was not, I would say the question, but the answer what you give about the cartel.
Yeah.
So you said the cartel is basically the both person are in the same room and they are having the same IP something. What the industry is going through is not the IP related to in a single room. That is a different way altogether, because that is, I'll say, just close to the cheating, I would say. If she's noting that means she's on the same pain which I am facing. So, okay. So this cartel, if I'll go a little bit, I can't go in depth, but if I'll go a little bit, it is just like that. you have a monthly something and you're deciding and others are following it. So that's a cartel, and if you go by that, whether you name it a plastic or a paper or whatever, any XYZ, how the AI or HI both put together, how they are going to help you? Maybe that can be a question I'm just putting, maybe if you have an answer right now or maybe later.
We can have a discussion. In fact, you know, the model that what we have today is when particularly in e-auction, this is respect to e-auction, okay, when there is a real-time bidding, okay, people will bid from their, you know, laptop or computers, right? That is how now days are gone where everybody has to come in the same room like us and they start bidding it, okay? No, so, but what happens that, you know, particularly in e-auction, you, for a particular item, okay, there is a collusion, okay? They try to disrupt the, either it may be with very high price, or a high bid, sorry, high bid, or with a very low bid, okay? So that is where, you know, they try to either ensure that, you know, this auction is not completed, or maybe during at the last minute they want to bid. So many things are there to rig the entire auction. That is where, you know, what we have seen that, you know, there was cartelization, and this is one of the examples where one of our customers are facing that. We have come up with reverse auction, okay? I think sir has also said that the way to, you know, break this cartelization is through auction. And that is where this is coming up, that yes, through this, at least this is only one of the mechanism, you know, IP tracking, okay? But this is very effective as of now. There is again AI not involved in. That's why I have, what I told, I would be covering AI, automation, and advanced analytics. So these are the three things. This cartelization IP is not a AI-based functionality, but this is where the automations and you know the analytics part will come into picture, particularly for e-auctions.
I just wanted to add something like on cartelization.
Uh-huh.
Same thing is happening in Coal India Limited auctions.
Yeah.
Coal India Limited auctions, they are always on e-platforms.
Yeah.
They know who are the people, those who are participating. And people also know each other.
Correct.
So they have a minimum benchmark for the coal, according to SEAM and mine. Mm-hmm. So all the bidders, they all know and they all sit together somewhere else and decide before the auction date that, okay, this is their basic price, will not go beyond this.
Correct.
So nobody will bid more than the base price.
Correct.
This is a kind of cartelization which, yes, people are following. And yes, you can't do it, do anything, track their IPs.
Correct. No, I agree with you. In fact, the coal example, we were in discussion with one of our customers, again, Tata Group customers, you know, they are into tea, and they mentioned, you know, the same kind of this thing, no? Even in tea, this is happening. Okay, they basically look into that one. But I think what we are trying to say that, you know, this kind of cartelization where people are there physically, okay, I think
they don't sit physically there.
They don't sit. They previously, beforehand only they decide on the price.
Yeah, because number of players are same and they know each other. I mean, they don't allow anybody else to enter.
Correct. They don't allow anybody else. I think this is one area where I'm sure at this point of time I don't have an answer how to break this mentality. Okay. But I am sure that, you know, with the advancement of so many, you know, new technologies that is coming up, okay, one day this will be also cracked. But at this point of time, maybe, you know, from AI perspective, but this is again, you know, human psychology. You can, you know, go to a extent, but you cannot go beyond that. So I am sure the things which were, you know, impossible, you know, 30 years back, today, it is one of the example is extended reality. I tell you one example. Even, you know, the way you, from the catalogs, right? If you have to select a laptop, okay? Normally what you do, you go to the catalog page, select, go to Dell or, you know, their website or then select that laptop. Those are, you know, gone days. Now, you know, if you want to buy a laptop, okay, there are applications, there are softwares, you know, you can go feel how the laptop looks like. You can type it, you can see. In fact, that's where the extended reality is coming into picture. So that's what I'm saying, that yes, things are changing, and I'm sure and I'm very hopeful that, you know, the way the technology is going, in fact, one day you need not to use your mobile to approve a purchase order or invoice. It's all here. Just approve it. Tick mark. Gone. Approved. So the things are going to come, and I think we, as a procurement professional, we would be waiting for those days. So I think with this, I would like to finish my presentation for the day. If you have any other questions, you are most welcome at our booth. We are very new in this TAP. Our product is TAP, but I'm sure that we have a backing of TCS. Okay, very big name. So we would be happy to connect with you at our booth. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, sir. And I would request you to please stay back. I would like to invite on stage Mr. Vipul Agarwal to please come forward and felicitate him.
Thank you so much.